Hello, this message is for Juan. This is PSA Echeverry from San Francisco Police Department. Just letting you know your Nissan was recovered. You're going to need two vehicle releases, one from CHP and then one from San Francisco Police Department.
All right, guys. So before I start the video, I thought it'd be a pretty good idea if I just showed you guys what the car was the very first day I got it and how I slowly built it up. So yeah, like you guys heard, I picked up the car for $400 back in like 2019. It was a single cam with an auto trans, but both of them were blown. I ended up having to tow it back home, but honestly it didn't last long at all because where I live there's HOA and they're already complaining about the car. Thankfully, one of my buddies that lived out in Vallejo, like an hour away from me, he offered me to store my car at his house. This was the car's new home for, I'd say, the next year and a half, as I basically saved up money for parts, for a new engine and a transmission, and just basically learned about cars because at this time I didn't know anything about cars. It was a bunch of trial and error, but eventually, little by little, we managed to fix all the stuff that was wrong with the car. Eventually, the day came where the car was running under its own power and it was basically ready to take back home. I still remember that first drive back. It was honestly hella sketch, but I didn't really care. I was just excited to have the car back.
Oh, shit, bro. Oh, my goodness.
You already know that the first stop, I had to link up with my brother to see both the cars in person for the first time. So at this moment, the car was super reliable. I was using it as my daily. So, you know what? It's time for upgrades. So I picked up a bunch of more hours at work. I even picked up another second job too, just so I could be able to afford more parts and to, you know, start making this thing look cool. I started out with the simple stuff. I ended up getting like S14 seats for it. I started upgrading like the speakers in the car since I wanted to have some music. Got a new stereo, just all the basic stuff to make it a good daily. At this time, it basically became an obsession just trying to make the 240 better and better each time, and little by little, it was actually getting there.
Five lug swap, new wheels in the back, the brake pads. I don't know if this is going clear though, brim.
So probably like a year in after building the car, I came across a 1JZ motor that I found on Facebook, and the guy told me he still had it running in his car, and he told me I could even come check it out. Most of you guys wouldn't have believed me if I told you this JZ came from a Prius. He gave us a test drive, the car felt great. So the next day I came back with the $2,600 cash and I picked up the motor. The JZ swap was on the go. Little by little, I started sourcing out all the parts, refreshing the motor, replaced what needed to be replaced, and just basically sourced everything that I needed for the swap because I didn't want the car to sit for long. Once I had almost everything that I needed to start the swap, my friend David offered to help me, and he even told me we could take the car to his house and start it there. So that's exactly what I did. And again, just like how we started, we kept working on it little by little, weekends by weekend, till we eventually got it running.
Go.
Thank you. motherfucker.
Hey, this bottle can work, huh?
Yeah, that shit works. Oh my god, we stupid, huh? Open downpipe, no hood. The 1J swap was running, basically took it back home. I already had a body kit for it waiting for me. Started mounting it up and just seeing how it would fit. Simple as it seems, like I ended up blowing two transmissions. I was having a misfiring issue, boost cut, but little by little we started fixing up all the issues that was wrong with it. Something that's worth to mention is that this car was literally built on the side of the road next to a middle school. Like I said, I lived in a HOA community, so they didn't let me work on my car at all.
I had to pull over and find my phone. Tell me you don't know these. Every day they come here and they straight rear end swaps, motherfucking hella shit.
Once we fixed all the minor stuff, the car was basically running mint on stock ECU, so I could finally enjoy it. I ended up going with more aero, got the new fenders, mirrors, M Sport hood, and eventually I saved up enough to go with a Link ECU just so I could have like full reliability with the engine and just to be able to get the most out of it. So once I had the hood on and everything, all the aero stuff, this is where things started to go bad. I'd say I only had the car like that probably like for a week or two. I was tuning it on the standalone and I started running into clutch slippage issues. Like the clutch didn't want to engage, so I basically just parked the car in my house for like a month while I saved up to get a new clutch kit. The clutch was slipping super bad, so I wasn't even, the clutch wasn't even engaging at all. So this is where things started to go to shit. I was like 2 hours away from home at my job and I got the notification on my phone that the GPS tracker was moving. To my luck, the GPS tracker just happened to be on low battery that day. And tell me why that the night before I was looking like crazy for the keys because I couldn't find them. And that shit ended up happening the next day. I was high-key going crazy too. I was over here looking for my car like a madman after work all day. Reposting my car all over IG, seeing a bunch of people help me out trying to see if they could keep eyes out for me. I even ended up DMing Mike Bike and he actually hooked it up and reposted it to on his story since he had a big following. And this is the last clip that I ever saw of the car. After that, the following days, after it got stolen, my phone was blowing up. People were telling me that they were seeing my car all over the Bay Area. Somebody told me San Jose, somebody told me Oakland, but honestly, I feel like they were probably just confusing it with somebody else's car. Until 2 weeks later, I got the call from CHP saying that they found my car in undrivable condition, but I never expected it to be the way that I found it.
Hello, this message is for Juan. This is PSA Echeverry from San Francisco Police Department. Just letting you know your Nissan was recovered. You're going to need 2 vehicle releases, one from CHP and then one from San Francisco Police Department.
I was kind of relieved when they called me and said that they found it, because for those 2 weeks that I was looking for it, it was nonstop every day after work, just thinking about the car, seeing if maybe it's still out there. And once I got that call saying that they found it though, I went to go check it out, and I never honestly thought that I would see that car in that condition. Just like that, 2-3 years of hard work was gone overnight. I honestly didn't even plan on getting another 240. I was just about to get out the game because I took a big L. I was like at least like $20,000 that I lost overnight. But my brother and all the people in IG that I met, everybody was being super supportive, and even people from all over the world ended up finding out about my car, and they were all just showing love. And honestly, they all motivated me to not let this end like this, and you know, just bounce back, get another hatch, and just rebuild it again, even though it's gonna cost a lot of fucking money. But at the end of the day, it's true. Like, I feel like I had something that I didn't finish, so I had to get my redemption. So I ended up picking up another black hatch, and that's the current one that you guys see on my channel that I've been building little by little. That's why it's called the V2, because I'm basically just trying to build it the same way that my old one was built, but just a little bit better in every way possible. Especially with everything that I learned from building my first 240, I feel like on this one I could correct all the stuff that I did wrong or a little jank, but yeah. I just want to end the video just saying, like, everything happens for a reason. Like, ever since that car got stolen, it kind of woke me up to, like, to go out there and get it twice as hard now. Like, now I had a motivation behind it. Also, I don't think I'm out here asking for pity or anything. It's just, I'm just trying to show you guys, like, if any of you guys ever go through something similar like this, maybe not a stolen car, maybe you crashed, totaled your car or whatever, it just goes to show, like, it's not the end of the world. Like, as long as you just get committed, put yourself out there, and just work hard, everything is achievable again. And if you did it once, you could definitely do it again. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I don't want to drag this video out too long. If you guys are interested on my new hatch, I'll go ahead and make a video on that and show you guys the build process on that. But currently, the KA blew up on me, like, last month. So I've just been saving up money, and hopefully this weekend I should be able to go buy the new motor for the new hatch. So yeah, fingers crossed, hopefully everything goes well. Also, you guys don't have to worry about this one getting stolen or anything. Well, at least not the same way that my old one did, because ever since that happened, I already moved houses. Like, I have a gated driveway now, and the car is in a much, much, much way better, safer spot. So yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. If you guys liked the video, just don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And if you guys want to see a full breakdown on my new hatch, just let me know. And I'll catch you guys next time. Y'all be safe. Peace.